On the agenda tonight, we're going to be comparing two versions of a classic track, and that track is They Long to Be Close to You. Hello, Phil here from Wings of Pegasus, and welcome to another analysis video. If you enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. So tonight's analysis video is a very specific one because I've been asked to compare two versions of They Long to Be Close to You, the Richard Chamberlain version, and the Carpenters version as well. You guys are probably most familiar with the Carpenters version of this song, and you can find Karen Carpenter playing drums on the channel here somewhere, where we analyze not only her drum playing ability, which was way up there, but also her vocal ability, which was definitely way up there as well. We're going to be looking mostly at the Richard Chamberlain version in terms of listening to the audio, because I'm not sure how it's going to work with copyrights. I don't want to get a block or a strike or anything by featuring two versions of a song, so we'll listen to Richard's version. I'll probably quickly jump over to the Carpenters version just to give an idea of what I'm talking about. But we will first of all jump into this version by Richard, and this was in 1963, I do believe, and the Carpenters released their version in 1970. We're just going to be looking at a slideshow here of Richard and listening to the recorded audio and the audio from the record. So let's see what this sounds like.
Time you are near, just like me, they long to be close to you. Why do stars fall down from the sky every time you walk by?
And there we have it. I thought I'd let it play all the way through because it's only just over 2 minutes in length, and a treat for any Richard Chamberlain fans out there because we just get to see lots of pictures of Richard. But jumping into the song and the way it's been put together, by the way, this is another Bacharach David song. So how many times have I said that on the channel? So many huge hits that those guys wrote, but this is such a different feel that we get from the Carpenters later on in 1970. What we've got here is a real emphasis on the beat, and we are totally straight here, which means that we haven't got any swing. It's just 1, 2, 3, 4, and we're going to be really emphasizing that straight beat, because the piano is, when you've got this 1, 2, 3, 4, the piano is going to be emphasizing ba 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 ba. like that. It's going to just keep on going. So it means that we got our 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Really straight. So just to demonstrate that fact, when we get into the chords, and by the way, I'm just going to play this on the guitar with the cap on the third fret, because as you may or may not know, the Carpenters version was in C, so it means that by putting the cap on that third fret, you can play this version if you want to, if you know the chords, and I'll just shout them out anyway, so you guys can play along if you've got your guitars out, because it's relatively straightforward. We're starting with our C. And when we get into the rhythm, it's really slow tempo-wise. This is another thing that's going to change when we then start talking about the Carpenters version. Theirs is a little bit more upbeat, therefore adding a little bit more excitement into the mix, making it slightly more interesting by introducing a faster tempo. But let's have a listen.
Birds suddenly appear.
So you can hear how we are so slow with our tempo, and because we're emphasizing every single one of those beats, then we're on the beat going 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, or the example that I gave earlier where we've got this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3. We really are just moving along as if we're playing the rhythm going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, just downstrokes the whole time. And by the way, C is where we're starting here, and I'm going to call out the chords here rather than calling this an E flat because of the capo. I'm just going to refer to it as a C so you guys can start playing it really quickly. So we've got the C, and then we'd go into what would be the B seventh, into the B minor seventh, into an E minor, into a C again, into a G. And those are your chords for the verse. So when we get into that and apply the rhythm, we've got this. Just straight down. And it really does drag along a bit. You kind of want to move it along a little bit. Let's get a little bit of a tempo reference again.
Every time you are near, just like me, they long to be close to you.
There we have it. So you can also notice how, because of that slower tempo, Richard is holding onto the notes for quite a long time. He's got that vibrato in there as well. You wouldn't say that Richard couldn't sing. He's definitely got a good voice, but it's just that the track feels like it's being held back a little bit. And of course, we're talking about this with hindsight, having heard the Carpenters version, and we're comparing it to that. So once you know that version, listening back to this, you will automatically think, oh, it's a little bit slow, and it does feel like it's being held back. That's only because you've heard the other version most likely first. Just when talking about ranges, I want to get the piano up on screen so you guys can see, as a reference point, where Karen was when she sang this range-wise. She had that contralto range, and when she said the money's in the basement, she meant that the notes were very low down for her, and that's where she made her money and had some huge hits with. So she was in this contralto range, which getting down here, actually, I believe in They Long To Be Close To You, she was around about D3, E3 as well, so even lower than the contralto range here, which starts at F3. So she was way down here, and if I now have a little transition into the male range, you'll see here that Richard, if I point it out, when I mentioned about the G2, that is down here, the bottom end of the baritone range and in the bass range. So when you're comparing these two together, at least vocally, they're doing the same thing. I mean, Karen's singing in a very low range for the female range, and Richard is singing in a very low range for the male range. So you've got a similar delivery, but it's the whole feel of the song, the tempo and the groove, that's really going to make the difference here. So I've taken the capo off the guitar, so we're going to be playing our C down in this position just normally, and we're going to start comparing the two songs and how they differ. When you really focus on those beats, and in this case, and it's actually slower than that, we have. When you're starting to do this, because the beats are being emphasized, it is really going to plod along, and I've mentioned this in other videos before, because you're emphasizing on the beat, it is like walking. And when you emphasize the offbeat and make it more syncopated, that's what it's called, emphasizing the offbeat, it starts to lift, because that's where you would have your foot up in the air if you relate this to walking. So on the beat, you're plodding along, especially if the tempo's slower, as this definitely is. But when you start adding in a little bit of emphasis on the offbeat, then it's going to lift it a little bit. What we get in the second track, when we're talking about the Carpenters version, they have a little bit of swing in there, which makes all the difference. And if I was playing that same riff that we just did, and we had this, and I'll try and play this. Kind of like that. It's not bad for a first attempt, but you can hear the bounce in there. So going da 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 da. The rhythm isn't going da 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 like it is in this particular version that Richard did in 1963. So hopefully you can hear the difference between those two. When we start getting into the song, we've got this. And that was me attempting to do a hi-hat, which we might be able to listen to in the Carpenters version. Like I said, I don't want this to get struck down by copyrights, but try and listen out. We're going to listen to a tiny bit of the Carpenters version. Listen out for the hi-hat and how we're getting that emphasis on those triplets.
On the day that you were born, the angels got together and decided.
Hopefully you can hear that. We've got that, which is going 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So just trying to count those in fours would absolutely do your head in, but it also shows you how we've changed the groove from a straight 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. You can already hear there's more going on, because there literally is, with just fitting more notes in to the same space that we had previously. But hopefully you can start to hear the difference between going straight 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Like that. And as you could notice there, I kept counting the fours without now counting those triplets, those double time triplets going on, so that you can hear all it is a change in emphasis, is a little bit of swing being thrown in there. So it means that when you're going 1, 2, 3, 4, you almost feel like you want to move more or bob your head, because of the emphasis now just falling in a place that isn't on the beat. We're just now throwing that swing in there, getting a little bit of more of an emphasis outside of that plodding along. We're now kind of like that. And you can see how that emphasis is coming in on the upstroke. And if I was doing more of that, going, you can start to hear how much of a different groove and feel that we're now applying to that rhythm that was really straightforward to begin with. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. And it is one of those things that once you start getting into the groove, it's just got so much more about it that you can start to latch onto. Something that I want to mention as well is Karen's background of being a drummer. And I don't think it's a coincidence that all the other versions of this song, like I said, Dionne Warwick released a version in 1964, Dusty Springfield in 1967. I don't think it's a coincidence that the thing that changed and made this into a monster hit for the Carpenters was the tempo and the feel, the groove. It's something that Karen would have been able to throw in there is something that she would have naturally been able to change with her background as a drummer. And certainly by increasing the tempo, changing the feel and the groove, it just elevated it to a different place where it's going to sound a lot more lively, but also it's going to have a knock-on effect on the vocal delivery and the cadence of that vocal delivery and the lyrical content. Because now there's not going to be straight singing, because in Richard's version, the vocal came in and it followed that plodding along of being on the beat. Whereas with Karen's singing, she's emphasizing the same triplet feel. So it means that even the vocal now is a little bit livelier. It's got a little bit more about it. But you can hear the impact of that as soon as the song starts off. We just have that little bounce in there and the increase in tempo. And it's not played on the guitar, but we've got that. And then we're going to be into the verse there. You can hear the bounce and the swing that we've got, so that now, when we're playing through that rhythm, we've got that little bounce. And into the E minor. These are the same chords that I played before when I described them up at the top here. So that was the C add 9 into the B 7th into the minor 7th, B minor 7th into the E minor into the C add 9. If you want to, you can. I took off my little finger on the G on the C add 9 before the G. Just steal a note from the melody to get it to sit in there, then you can do that. But you can hear how with that picking we're going bum 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 ba. There's a little bit of a change in that groove and just putting in that swing. This has a massive impact on the lead vocal, because Karen, when she's singing this, she's following the groove of the backing. And it's exactly the same case for Richard. When he's singing it, he's following the groove of the backing, so he's singing very straight, and Karen's singing with swing. To give an example of the effect that this has on the lead vocal, I'm going to just phrase it straight in terms of the way that Richard does it, and we've got this.
Why do birds suddenly appear every time you are near?
So you can hear there, a really obvious part is suddenly, where we have
why do birds suddenly appear,
like that. Whereas when we put the swing in there, we have this
why do birds suddenly appear.
You can hear
sa da 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 da.
We've got a little bit of that triplet sound in there,
da 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 da,
rather than da 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 da, just being on the beat. So doing that again, we have
why do birds suddenly appear every time you are near?
And again, exactly the same thing there.
Every time.
It's
every time,
not every time. And straight, it's got that little hop in there.
Every time you are near.
And exactly the same thing there. So you'll find that just running throughout the Carpenters version. Just this bounce, a little bit more energy, it's more lively, and it's exaggerated when we get into the part where we've got this.
On the day that you were born, the angels got together and decided to create a dream come true.
That part, when we've got this,
da na 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 na,
you can instantly hear the swing in there and the emphasis, how it's changed from now singing straight to following that backing, following the rhythm. Just to quickly show you guys the chords that I just played through there, because I haven't gone through those ones yet. We've got the C add 9 into the B minor 7th into the E 7th to the C add 9 into the D. And that D is is where we have the... There's a little piano rundown that comes in that emphasizes those notes, but that's where your D comes in and then it's back into the verse. So this was a really specific video request asking me to compare Carpenter's version with Richard Chamberlain's version, considering that he released it earlier. Why wasn't it a huge hit? And the main reasons are because of that lift that it was given when Carpenters released it. And the Carpenters version had Karen's voice on, and her voice was just one in a billion anyway. But once you add the extra liveliness in there, giving it that lift, increasing the tempo, that's what really made it stand out, having that swing in there. And just to mention that Dionne Warwick's version in 1964, she kept it the same. It was the same as Richard's in terms of that groove. It was straight and the tempo was slow. When Dusty Springfield released her version, it now had an increase in tempo, but it didn't have that swing until we get to 1970. And it's when I think probably most likely Karen had a bit of a play with it on the drums, started to change up that groove, and then added her silky smooth vocal to it. And it really just lifted the whole song. And that's why it was just a massive hit. It was that perfect storm of having the perfect vocalist and making the perfect changes to that original track. But thank you guys for requesting this video, a very specific one for tonight. But keep those suggestions coming in the comments below. Let me know what you guys think. And if you did enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. And I'll see you guys at the next one. Rock!